the same initials. I did not think about that whenever I created the team. Let's see what I've got on the trading block here. If I can get there. So I've got Cody Franzen and Carter Hutton up here on the trade block, as well as a fourth round pick in the upcoming entry draft on the trade block. And I'll let you see the lines here so we can see how everybody has been performing. Alright, so we got, looks like our top line has definitely been our top performing line. Most goals, 7 goals, and then Thomas Jurco getting 3 on the second line here. And then Alexander Bremestrov getting 2 goals for us here on the fourth line, actually. Doesn't look like our third line. Yeah, third line's got 4 assists, and that's it. So the third line not performing too well. And just due to that, I think I'm going to switch fast and Bremestrov, see if we can get some. Well, put him back because now the fourth line doesn't have any points except 1. So we'll leave that there. And don't forget to look at the defense to see what those lines look like. Matthias Ekholm and Sammy Botman on the top pairing. So they have 6 assists, and then Jonas Brodin and Zach Bogosian on the second line, and then Brandon Manning and Alex Prejevich on the third line. Alright, so this will be the first game that I will be actually playing here. So we will see how this team does and see if we can pick up our third win on the season. They got Barlamov in goal, just over in line, save percentage with 2. And you see Carter Hutton must have had a pretty bad game for his third game. He had a 2.5 save percentage before that last turn. Now he's up to 3, so I'm guessing that something happened there. And just so you're all aware, they did not have Cottonmouth or Snakes as a option for the in-game commentary, so it'll be called the Pythons as we pick up our first penalty of the game here, tripping call. Get saved by Carter Hutton there. And I hope that I don't think I did, because I didn't feel like that actually felt like 27 seconds. So I think the penalties are actual time here. Yeah, they are. So a penalty is actually going to be 2 minutes here and not up to speed with the game clock. So it might be kind of difficult to kill off some of these penalties sometimes, since you actually have to do a full 2 minutes. good save by Hutton there. Pick up the rebound. Get it cleared. There we are, so we're down to 5 seconds on the penalty now. Seems like we're going to kill off our first penalty of the game. There we go, pick up our first goal of the game. Not sure who that was there. Someone in 45, not sure who that is. We'll see here in a second who scored that. That was Sammy Votnin, so that was our D coming into play here. It's a good shot, open in the slot, and buries it home in the bottom right. Assist for Abedeker and Zingle. So that's good. We'll try not to give up another goal here. Abedeker up the wing. He's going to pass it back to Clutterbuck and off to Votnin. Votnin gets laid out and passes it out for offsides. Benito with the puck here. He gets leveled but still manages to come up with the puck. Back to Clutterbuck, off to Ekholm. And we get a power play here. I believe it should be tripping. Went for the slide to block the shot and ended up tripping. Yeah, there it is. So we get a tripping call there. That'll put us on the power play. We should be able to hopefully score. Here. So we get the puck already. Now we're going to try and get this set up here. Where's the puck? Carlson's got it. Alright, is it clear? That's not what was supposed to happen. Get an icing for it. You never want to have to ice the puck when you yourself are on a power play. As we win the face-off back, and Remy Schwab heads up the wing here. Kind of finds a crease, passes it back to Ekholm. Good save by Hutton there. We really need to get this power play set up here and see if we can do something on it, but unfortunately it does not look like we're going to do it there. There we go. Now that we kind of got this set up. Deflection in there for our second goal. I think Jerko might have gotten that one. I think that's who got that one. So that puts us up 2-0 midway through the first period here. Yeah, Thomas Jerko got that one. Fourth goal of the season. I believe this is our fourth game, so very good for him. Takes a slap shot and gets a deflection in. through the 5-hole there. So, you know, up 2-0. This is from Ekholm and Benishrov on the power play there. So they're now up 2-0 over the Colorado Avalanche about midway through the first period here. Duchesne gets a good shot there in the slot. Luckily, it's saved by Hutton. Supposed to be a pass. Luckily, now that was a terrible hybrid icing call right there. We definitely got that puck down before they did. Hutton gets a good save there. With the faceoff there in our defensive zone, and we are heading back down the ice. Nino gets a good shot there on goal, but it is saved by Verlamo. See if they're winning the face-off 6-4, which is always a plus. Now it's up to 7-4 with that last one. It's not what was supposed to happen there. Let's see, they score. What a save by Hutton there to prevent the first Colorado goal of the game. 3-2-1. That will be the end of the first period. Up 2-0 on the Colorado Avalanche. Hopefully we can keep up the momentum in the second period and come out with our third win of the season already. There's the second goal on the power play from Jerko as the Columbus Cottonmouths are up 2-0 on the Colorado Avalanche going into the first intermission. You can see the stats there. They definitely had the advantage in the shot column, but luckily Carter Hutton is being pretty clutch on the in the net there and helping us do that. Luckily, though, we are winning the faceoffs. That's always something you want to be ahead in. As I say that, we lose the faceoff, but Bonino manages to fight back and win the puck off the draw there as we pass it around here, trying to get a open shot here as Clutterbuck picks it up. Across to Ekholm, takes a shot. Good save by Varlamov. As we are now 2 minutes into the second period. As Ekholm takes a shot there from the blue line there. Another good save by Marlon Mom to keep the game 2-0. And there we go. We are heading back to the power play. I believe that might be either a hooking or slashing call. Let's see here. Yeah, I think he got him for hooking. You saw his arm go back. Yeah, hooking. Nathan McKinnon. So, 17:21 left in the second period. We will be back on the power play. Hopefully, we can have just as good a success on this one as we did in the last one here. As we are hitting up the ice here to see if we can score our second power play goal of the game. Broke his stick there. That's never good. So Colorado will clear it back down the ice. Carlson's got this one between the blue lines. Let it go. Scooped up by Carlson. Cleared. A lot of work, but penalty time less and less now. Columbus with it in their own end. Into the attacking end. Sends to the point. Gives it on a cross from the point. From the outside. Finally lifted back out so they can get some fresh troops out. Passing one off now to Yurko. And he steps across the line. Let's the shot fly. Great glove save. And a pretty decent power play so far. I've gotten some good shots on goal, but Varlamov has been pretty clutch in net, stopping everything we have thrown at him so far. We've got 25 seconds left here on the power play, see if we can get something going in that short amount of time here as we win the draw. Ekholm takes a slap shot there, but nothing home. And we get a good one-time goal there. Not sure who got the assist on it, but that was... Look at that, they want some free merch. So Justin Abdelker gets the third goal of the game for us. We're now up 3-0 against the Colorado Avalanche.
Thrown to Clutterbuck. Gets in. What'll he do? With a shot. Loose puck brought in by Bonino. Hammered. Wonderful save. Puck covered. Whistle blown.
There we go. We are heading back to the power play again. Another tripping call. I believe it was that same. Went for the. No, that one was just a blatant. A little more interference than it did tripping, but that's what they got. The Appalachian player for was tripping. We head back to the power play here for the third time today. Already 2-for-2 on the power play. Hope that we can convert again, get our third goal.
Do you see a pattern developing here? They're up now by three.
almost able to keep it in there, but we get possession back. And, able to keep it in, but then, that should be the end of the game. So now we'll be on a 5-on-3 power play for a minute and a half. There's absolutely no excuse not to score on a 5-on-3. There we go. Score our fourth goal of the game. There's Boomer. Get Pipe. I think we are now up 4-0 over the Colorado Avalanche midway through the second period. And not sure if that was a special goal for him, first NHL goal or something. Looked like a little different animation there. I'm thinking that's probably what that was. There we go, looked like the goalie was screened by number 13 there. And Bogostan gets his first of the season on the power play. It'll probably tell us here if that was his first NHL. No, didn't see that, but I'm thinking that's what it might have been. I'll have to check on that after the game. And with, even though we scored on the power play there, we are still on the power play because that was a 5-on-3. So, we're still on the power play for another minute and a half, and unfortunately, we give up a shorthanded goal to make it 4-1. Tyson Yost, his second goal of the season. Just some bad defense there that led to their first of the game. But, still on the power play. Hopefully, we can convert and get that goal back. Here we go, get another shot on net there. We're now 59 seconds through the power play. And you can see we are 3-for-3 on the power play with 7 shots. Sammy Vatanen blocks that one down to prevent it from going back down the ice. He's going to take it up, take a wrist shot, but it gets deflected. This one will be cleared all the way down. Brodin's got it in the defensive zone, headed to center. Pythons have control of the puck in the defensive zone. Laid on to Deneau. Back to the point. Ripper got through. It's almost like he's on autopilot. He's hurt, but he's just trying to finish the shift as he's banged up. Looking for options in their own end. Looks like one of the announcers just said there that the Avalanche defenseman who blocked that shot was injured on the play. So we'll have to keep an eye on that and see if they've got an injury there. As we now do not convert on our first power play of the game. Wait for some help here. Ekholm takes a slap shot, misses the net. This will be the first time in a while that we played some 5-on-5 hockey here. Oh, and we are heading back to the power play now that I mentioned 5-on-5 hockey. And we've been streaming for 38 minutes here. There is a setting that I'm going to have to turn down after this this match. That is the setting where It's that power play length. So, like, right now, the power plays are actually 2 minutes long, which isn't very nice, because even though, you know, I can score a lot, you know, it takes up too much time and makes the games drag on forever, especially if you get a lot of power plays like this. And it's extremely difficult to kill off a full two-minute power play in this game. A little bit more difficult to score on a two-minute power play. But it's very difficult to actually... There we go. Get another goal here. Fifth goal. I believe Carlson may have got that one. I think I saw his name pop up down there. Yeah, Mikko Carlson. First goal of the season on the power play. And Ekholm gets the primary assist on that one. And Bobrovsky gets the secondary. See, before these goals have been on the power play today, so that's why I want to turn down the power play 2 minutes, just due to the fact that it takes forever to kill off a power play, and it's very easy to score in a full 2 minutes, being 5-on-4. There we go, another good save by Hutton. Now that should be a tripping call right there, or hooking. Put us back on the power play. Gonna see if I can wait here for the, let's see if I can wait for the sixth man to get down there and help us out on the offense there. Missed the open shot there. I almost gave away a goal on the shorthanded there. Oh no, it was his 50th career goal, not his first. And unfortunately committed a tripping penalty there right before the end of the period. So it's 4-on-4 for the next 58 seconds, and then they'll be on the power play, but still up 5-1. And the, see if we can get a shot off here. We do, and it goes in! Oh my goodness, what a goal there. With 0.4 seconds left in the period. I believe that was Jesper Fast. Yeah, it was. I had 20 minutes into the period. Definitely did not think we were going to be able to score there, but we were. So that's where it definitely benefits to win those faceoffs. And there you see they're going to be switching goalies from Varlamov to number 31 here. Not sure what his name is. They're not going to tell us. I'll have to look in the menu after this. And I'm not sure if I can change up the penalty time length here in the, there's the stats, let's see here, settings, game settings, no, I don't have it in here, but I could change the difficulty, which I thought about doing, have to do that after the game, rules, I don't think it's under the rules, oh it is. So penalty time scaling. So the game is set to 4 minutes. So I think we'll put this at a 3, and that'll be a 1 minute power play in total. And then coincidental, we'll change the percentage of real time used during shorthand. We'll change that down to 4, just to make that a little bit better as well. There we go, we got that switched, and I think I should have to still change it in the menu after the game. And that's a face-off win. That was the wall that stopped. Good, quick stick. Colorado's controlling play now. Big hit from Bob in there to dislodge the puck. But they still get it back. Duchesne with a move. Saved by Hutton. Bobman gets the puck. Drag between the blue lines. Got that pass near the blue line and now looks ahead. Moving it now. And they are now on the power play. As Duchesne gets it, and what is saved by Hutton. As we are now on the penalty kill here. Just going to see if I can get this in deep. And cause some chaos here. Not what I wanted to do. Is definitely not give him a breakaway. Another good save by Hutton. And clear it. And that will kill off the penalty kill for us. As we are up 6-1 over the Avalanche. Now have 8 minutes left here in the third period. Missed the open net there. Gotta hit those. Even though the score is 6-1, and we are gonna get. get the win here. Still definitely want to hit those open. Open that shot. There you go. You see our next three games against the Hurricanes, Canadians, and Devils. All three of those games will be simulated. So hopefully we can pick up three wins in those games. There we go. No icing. Oh, pass it to the wrong guy. Pass it to the middle of nowhere. Passing one off now to Bogosian. Two sticks together, it goes to the offense. The Python starting back in their own end. Solid defensive play to break up the rush. Good intercept. So we're into the last minute. All is academic here. Shoots one. Columbus in their own end, controlling play now. He gains the zone. Shoots one. Took that wrist shot. Oh. Another open net miss. There for Abidelker, I believe that was. And, 30 seconds left here in the game. We're going to close this one out. What should be a 6-1 victory against the Columbus or the Colorado Avalanche. Get the names mixed up. The initials being the same. At Columbus as well. Good save by Hutton. Abidelker on the breakaway. Cannot make it 7-1. But that will end the game. And we will win our first divisional matchup against the Colorado Avalanche. There you can go. We see we were at 90% plus on everything. There's the game stats. 6 goals on 27 shots. 4-for-6 on the power play, which I turned that down, so hopefully in the following games won't be that successful. But we were able to win the majority of the face-offs, and 3 stars of the games. Ekholm with 4 assists. Wow, that's phenomenal for him. Carter Hutton, the second goal, second star in the game, and Abidelker on the third star with the goal and an assist. Alright, so now I'm going to go ahead and simulate up to the 31st here. So that would be Carolina, Montreal, New Jersey, Tampa Bay, and Arizona. We'll see what we can do there. Start off the streak with a 2-0 loss and a amateur scout call. Let's get some more scouting here. Let's do defenseman. OHL, and then we got Montreal, a 5-0 loss, not good, and a 5-2 loss to New Jersey, and it looks like we have a trade offer here. We're going to look at this one, see if this is something that we want to do. So they're going to be sending us Sean Mathias here as a 78 overall left winger. $2 million one way. Some pretty good stats for our fourth round pick, which is what we had up on the trade block, so that's good. I think if I do this, just for fun, I'm going to see if I can get a fifth back. I'm not going to do that. Let's try a sixth or a seventh, and they don't take that, so we're just going to take that out, and I actually think I'm going to accept this trade. But I am going to see, just for fun, see if they will keep $1 million on his contract, just to make things a little bit better for me, and they're not going to do that. Let's see if we can work him down to $500,000. Don't do that either. Didn't mean to clear him out. Let me get him back up on there. If he was a left winger, yeah, Mathias. What if we could get Pearl instead? No, I'm not going to do him. Looks like we'll have to go with Mathias, and I will accept this trade. Looks like if we do that, we're going to have to send Clifford down. So I'm actually going to cancel that right now. And then cancel the simulation as we suffer four straight losses against the Hurricanes, Canadians, Devils, and Lightning. The offense not very good. 4 goals in 4 games while giving up 2, 7, 12, 19 goals in those 4. So that's definitely not good. So I'm going to go to my roster here and see what we can do. See if we can send somebody else down. So Clifford was the one who was going to have to be sent down. Kyle Clifford here. So it looks like everybody here would have to be sent down. Let me check my scratch. So even though all three of these guys here are on one-way contracts, so they would have to be sent down if we add one more player to the roster. So I like what we've got going on. I don't really want to change anything. So I think I'm going to keep what we've got so far, and not do that trade with the I can't remember who that was. All right. There we go. So that makes me feel a little bit better. He said it's going to be a good year for rookies, so that's obviously a plus. So we go 1-4 on the 5 simulated games. So that will wrap up the first month of the season. Finish 4-5-0. Not too bad. Looks like our offense was good. Offense was good in the games that we won, but in the games we lost, they were not very good. However, our AHL team is 6-3-0, which is not bad at all, and they've got some good wins and some bad losses. An 8-1 loss and a 7-4 loss. Back-to-back games. I never really want to see that.